Anthropologists estimate that as much as 2.5 million years ago, modern man began to walk upright from their original homeland of the woods and migrate into the savanna. But the hominid that walked could only do so by the remarkable structure of the vertebral curve, which is, from an evolutionary perspective, a one-of-a-kind feature of morphological development that would distinguish these bipedal creatures from any other organism on the planet Earth. These curves are unique to the human race. Together, the cervical, thoracic, and lumbar portions of the vertebrae protect the spinal cord and help support the weight of the upper body. However, the thoracic vertebrae are the only vertebrae that work to provide essential support for the ribcage as well as maintain the body's stance and stature. Unlike the cervical and lumbar portions, the thoracic region of the vertebral column maintains a stability that is essential for the protection of the body's inner organs. This is because the body of the thoracic vertebrae is located on the posterior thorax and is both medial and posterior to the ribs. This design helps maintain a limited flexibility, which can hold the body upright and keep the ribcage stationary for the sake of the internal organs in the chest. What this means is that the thoracic vertebrae, along with the ribs, help our organs stay safely in place. The first thoracic vertebra, identified as T1, is the smallest vertebra of the thoracic column. Uniquely, T1 is the meeting place of the cervical and thoracic vertebra. There, the head of the first rib articulates with the thoracic fossa. Thoracic vertebra T2 through T9 are generally similar in structure and function. Anatomically, the 8 vertebra have a ventral body with superior and inferior fossa. They do not have 2 coastal demi-fossa like T1, but instead have a fossa on their transverse bodies. This singular fossa is used to articulate ribs. The flat fossa of the thoracic vertebra also form the joints between the vertebra and the ribs. These plantar joints are concave in shape, and they work to allow for multi-axial free movement. The structure of these joints allow for activities such as bending, leaning, and dancing. T9 is located near the end of the thoracic vertebra and corresponds with the adrenal glands via nerves. T9 is significantly larger than the other bodies of the thoracic vertebra, but its size is necessary to stabilize the posterior surface of the spine. Singularly, T9 does not articulate to the ribs at all. T9 marks the first of the lower thoracic, which work to protect the lungs. The particular design of T9 is commonly known as a thoracic cage. T9 is the first of the transitional vertebra. T9 through T12 lower thoracic bodies are transitional because they show the gradual change from thoracic to lumbar. The transition from thoracic to lumbar can be seen in the anatomy of T9 through T12. As the thoracic vertebra gets lower and closer to the floating ribs, the structure is more like the lumbar vertebra. Therefore, like the lumbar vertebra, T9, T10, and T11 are susceptible to compression fractures that appear with age or arise from complications due to osteoporosis. The lower thoracic vertebra include T9 through T12. Like T9, T10 does not contain inferior coastal fossa and does not directly articulate with the false 11th ribs. However, T10 is similar to T9 because of its flat surfaces on the superior and inferior surface of the centrum, which allows for articulation of joints between the bodies of T9 and T11. Additionally, the shape of the spinose process gradually transitions to a horizontal position as the thoracic column ends. This is due to the lumbar column directly below. T10 is designed to function in a way that holds the body upright, much like the lumbar vertebra. The 11th thoracic body articulates with only the heads of the 11th ribs, and they do not have fossa on their smaller transverse process for articulation of the ribs. This is because of the gradual change that makes the last of the thoracic more lumbar-like in formation. Instead of articulating with the ribs from the fossa, the last two thoracic vertebra contain the surface for rib articulation that is on the pedicle instead of the centrum. Like T9, T11 is significantly larger. T11's large shape is necessary, for it must provide support for the central spine. The last of the thoracic vertebra is also the largest and the strongest of the 12 because it must carry the weight of everything above it. The strength of T12 is necessary because of its location at the trunk of the thoracic column. Like the lumbar vertebra, T12 is constricted laterally and has inferior articular surfaces that are convex and contains lamina and spinosis process. Thus, because it is so low, T12 more closely resembles the lumbar vertebra than any of its thoracic family in anatomical structure and function. Like the lumbar vertebra, the large T12 is essential for bearing the weight above it. T12 is also useful for the absorption of shock signals. T12 contains intervertebral discs, which are slightly flexible in order to absorb shock. These specialized discs also help prevent the vertebra from collapsing into one another. Certainly, the thoracic column of the vertebral spine is especially vital to the structure and function of the human spinal cord. As the thoracic column merges into the lumbar vertebra, it begins an eventual transition into the similar structure, providing additional support in keeping the human body stable and upright. The size and design of the thoracic vertebra make an ideal support system for the spinal cord. Additionally, the thoracic column provides a place for articulation for the ribs, protecting the inner organs from damage caused by unseen outside forces. This video on the thoracic vertebra and articulating ribs was completed as a part of the course requirements for human anatomy at Saddleback College.